Welcome to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggy. And you know, I just hate it when I have to have Norma quit singing that song. It's my favorite song. Well, welcome. And we have John Orlando with us tonight and Norma Nelson. So praise God. We got a full room here. And we just had so many miracles that have happened throughout the week. And we met John. It's really kind of funny. Just on Saturday. And he just knocked on our door, and he's a salesman, and he was there from 4 o'clock about till about midnight, I think it was. And it was obviously a divine appointment. So we'll just let you tell a little about what happened that day, okay? And then on Sunday, too, he came for our church service Sunday morning.
Absolutely. Well, to be honest with you, I wasn't really looking for anything to happen that day. I just basically woke up that morning, and I was going through some stuff personally with my wife and myself. And basically, the Lord got a hold of me that morning, and it didn't stop from the very moment I woke up that morning till 4 o'clock in the afternoon when I knocked on his door. And I was basically trying to sell him trash service. And he said, come on in. And I was like, he was just like, just come on in. So I came on in, and we started talking. And one thing led to the next. And I asked him if he was a minister. And he said, yes, he's a minister. And then a little bit later on, I couldn't stop talking about God, and we were just kept talking about God. And then the presence of the Spirit of God started like jolting me and like getting a hold of me, and just it just went on for hours and hours. What seemed to be like just a few minutes turned was actually hours and hours and hours. And so then the next day I came to church, to the ministry, and you guys allowed me to sing a song that actually started this whole process back over, because I used to go to church a lot and I used to pray a lot, but it's been a while. So praise God. You know, it has a way of reaching out and you know, grabbing you whenever you're down.
And sometimes God just makes those divine appointments. And he just reaches out where you're at, wherever you are, and he finds you, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
And you just felt the power of God go through you. It's like you just kept getting shaken and shaken.
Over and over again.
It was like truths from God would just hit you, and it was just like, wow. Yeah. Yes. Okay, God, I get it.
Constant confirmation of things that we were talking about.
Right.
And then the Holy Spirit would just rise up within me, and I was like, whoa. And this is like just the beginning, obviously, I think, you know.
Amen.
You know, it's like, you know, you turn a corner, and you go around that corner, and all of a sudden you run into Jesus, you know, and whoa. You know, he's right there in front of you, and you can't get around him. Sometimes you try to run away, you know. You try to run away the other direction, and, you know, everywhere you go, you turn, the roadblocks are there, and Jesus is the roadblock. You know what I mean?
Yes. So. And you used to be a youth pastor.
Well, I was never really full-fledged into that. No, yeah. I was more into music.
Yeah,
I did,
okay.
One time... Sort of
helping,
helping out. Yeah, it was a long time ago.
So obviously, God just wanted to get you back into the ministry again, huh?
I think so.
Yes, I know so.
Yes,
I know so.
Yes, yeah. We were talking to a guy today a little bit earlier, and he was speaking over me, prophesying, and. And John walked into the room, and he said something about playing the piano. I don't play the piano. He was speaking to you.
And me and James could see where, because he was from another state, he could see it. He sees, like, into our house, and he knew that was coming from our house, but he wasn't sure that, because he was speaking to Patty, he didn't realize that you walked in the room.
Right. Yeah. I was trying to get ice out of the ice cube maker from the... from the refrigerator there, and I heard that, and I stopped.
It's like, you know? Oh.
And then again, I started getting jolted again by,
yep, you know. He's talking about him.
Yeah.
I've learned a long time ago that God can't honor my word, but he can honor his word. So whether mm-hmm. it's a written word or prophetic word, you'll see the manifestation of power when you speak it.
Amen.
And that's how I fine-tuned me, was, wow, I want to see that. I want to get it right on, so when I speak, I want to speak God's word. And that's why these people that speak a lot of words, they're just noise. It's like, well, Paul says, like clanging cymbals.
Clanging cymbals, mm-hmm. yeah.
And that's why I get frustrated, because you're just going around that merry-go-round again. Just speak what God shows you, and bang, bang, yep. miracles will just happen.
Yep, it'll hit people. They'll know it was from God.
Well, it's hard to argue when the power of God's hitting you.
That's true. That's true.
Yes, it is.
And that's where Paul says, I do not preach with elegant words. But in the church, mostly we have a lot of elegant words, and they go to school learning how to speak good. I don't know how to speak good. Curry don't. But we know how to listen and speak what God's saying.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And then that's the bang, the power of God's hitting them.
And I knew that you were gifted, because yesterday morning when you started playing, it's like the power of God just hit me, and it made me just about start bawling. I could just feel the anointing come off when you were playing. You weren't singing, you were just playing.
Mm, okay.
But, you know, God does that with different people.
Sure.
And so I just knew as soon as it happened that, yeah, it was from God. Like Norma, when she sings, which she's going to later, praise God. But the anointing comes off when she sings. So it's just such a blessing. We had to have them both here tonight.
That's awesome.
God's putting a team together.
Yep.
And he's calling them in from every direction.
Yep.
I mean, you couldn't have planned that divine connection the other day.
No, I would have never planned that.
It was like we met Norma. She was just going to come because we're still into some traditions. You know, we needed somebody to sing.
Mm-hmm.
And the first time I heard her sing, the power of God just started hitting people. You're the third person now that I've met. When they sing or play, the power is there. You'll get see
Amen.
People get healed, delivered, born again, filled with the Holy Ghost. I don't praise listen God. To these ears. I listen to this ear.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I see people. I see their potential.
Right.
And our job is to call them up to be like Christ. Jesus healed them all, and we're supposed to get everybody activated and walking in this.
Amen. So you said you have prayed for people yourself, or you have personally been healed from God. Can you tell some of the testimonies?
Well, years ago when I was going to church a lot, I used to have a friend. His name is Ron, and now he's in Florida. And we used to go out and evangelize in downtown St. Louis and preach the gospel to people.
Cool.
Like, we would walk down the alleys where I don't know if it sounds racist, but no white guy would go down that, uh-huh. that area, because it was just dangerous. And so we were together like a team, and, you know, it was the middle of the night. It was on New Year's Eve one night. We went downtown St. Louis. There was a block party going on, and all these people, these pagans, were running around banging drums and playing all kinds of weird music and wearing all kinds of weird costumes and stuff. But we went to that that meeting. We were actually driven there with somebody else, and we decided this wasn't for us. So we left the meeting. We got our money back, and we left the meeting. Well, the people that drove us there were still at the meeting. So we left. We went out walking down the street, and, you know, we went down this back alley, and, man, I was kind of afraid, but my friend Ron doesn't have any fear at all, okay? And he's just filled with the Spirit all the time. And this one guy was trying to rape this girl right there, and he just, in the name of Jesus, I command you to stop!
Oh, amen. Good.
And that guy stopped, but he couldn't do anything. He was just stopped. He was like handcuffed. He couldn't chase us. He couldn't do anything. And the lady ran off, and then
praise
we just
God.
Kept walking, and then we walked past this other full gospel church that was for some reason, I guess it was because it was New Year's Eve, they were having a meeting.
Yeah.
And so we went into there, and there was a prophetic church, and that whole thing went on, and we got our feet washed. It was pretty wild. The guy got up there, and the prophet got up there and started prophesying and prophesied to almost all these people in the church. And then we got a Rally's hamburger, and then we turned around and walked back. Well, as we were walking back, the car that we came with was leaving, and it met us.
Oh, wow.
So it's just amazing how timing and everything, and divine appointments and, you know, things that can happen. And it's just the beginning. I mean, there's so many things that used to happen all the time, and I basically had been away from all that for a long time, too. But, yeah, miracles happen all the time. Some of them are just small little miracles. Some you know, just the fact that you're breathing sometimes is a miracle.
Yeah.
You know,
amen.
I mean, almost had a car run me over one time, and it wasn't able to kill me. You know,
praise God.
You know, things of that like that. But yeah, there's been all kinds of really interesting things that have happened. One time we baptized a guy in his house. We led him to Jesus, and we baptized him right in his bathtub.
Yeah.
In his house. That night, and just I can't. I mean, there's a lot of it, for instances in the past.
Have you been healed of anything yourself?
We prayed the other night, and my back was really, really sore,
uh-huh.
Really, really sore, and I think that my healing is still, I mean, my back's still being restored, but it was a lot better, mm-hmm. way better than it was when I went in,
yeah,
came into your house. So that's
praise God.
Well, you prayed for somebody Sunday and they got healed.
I did.
Yeah, the guy that fell on the couch.
He was. I didn't know he got healed.
I don't know what it all was right now.
Anxiety.
Yeah. Oh yeah, anxiety.
Yeah, John. Yeah. So praise God, he told us that, you know. That's what it was, and he just wanted to get rid of it.
That was pretty awesome.
When's the last time you had that happen when you prayed for somebody?
I've never had anybody fall back like that or shake or anything like that ever. And I've never felt the presence of God so much while I was praying for somebody.
Amen.
Anything.
It's where it says, blessed, more blessed to give than to receive.
Yes.
That's why I do it. I'm like, wow, I like that.
It's pretty amazing.
You get the after, and you got to experience it. Wow, that was better than having somebody pray for me, was to release the kingdom into
right.
somebody else.
Amen.
You get more than they get. Yeah. And Norma was praying for people around the counter there, and you got hit with the power of God. When you said now, when you're praying somebody over the phone, everybody in the room got hit with the power of God.
Yep. Amen.
They've seen you grow so much. Now it's just bang.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yep, thank you, Lord.
You get more done with that one release in the kingdom than you will with all the prayers in the world.
Yeah.
It just, there's no way the devil can defend the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And you were praying for somebody over the phone the other night, too. I don't even remember who that was, but they could feel it when you were praying over the phone.
Yeah.
They said that.
Wasn't that Saturday night?
Yeah, that was Saturday
yeah,
night.
Yeah, there's been so much that's happened in 2 days. I can't even remember
like
it all.
It's like 2 months.
I mean, it feels like a week, and it's only been 2 days.
Yes, it has. God is good.
Oh, wait till we take you with us out of state. It just goes up to a new realm.
Amen.
Right?
Yeah.
Arkansas, Milwaukee, it was just bang, 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 bang.
Wow.
So have you prayed for anybody else before when you were ministering more that you saw them healed?
Oh, yeah. The first time I've ever seen anybody healed was when I was basically at a church in St. Louis, and I was being mentored to be a youth pastor at that time, and there was a prayer walk in the back of this church, and it was a big, giant, like, woodsy area that it was all overgrown with mm-hmm. all kinds of, you know, vegetation. So I thought it would be a good idea to go out there and take the youth group and clean up that whole back area back there. Well, when we went back to go clean it up, one of the girls had a really bad ankle, and she couldn't walk very far. It was a really long walk. It was down a hill, and you know, it's kind of treacherous a little bit, but we were trying to make it so it wasn't going to be that way anymore. So when we went back in there, when I realized that she couldn't walk any further, I said, let's turn around and go back. So we went back and we sat around this picnic table. And I was really reading the Bible a lot at the time, and I knew that the Bible said that by his stripes you are healed. I knew that the Bible said that if you lay hands on sick people, they will recover. It's not a matter of they might recover or they might if they do this, this, and this. It was they will recover. And so I told the youth group that we all need to basically take and lay hands on her and pray for her in the name of Jesus and that she would be healed. And so we did. And I remember praying that Jesus was Jesus is the, you know, he's healing to all the nations, and that healing is the children's bread. And if you just partake of Jesus, that you'll be healed. And we prayed. I asked her, how's your foot feel? And she pulled her sock off, and it was still all bruised and battered and messed up. And she said, well, it still hurts. I said, that's okay. It'll be healed. Sometimes it takes a little bit of time, you know. And so we went into the church after that. We watched this movie called A Knife and a Switchblade, which is about Nicky Cruz.
Yeah.
And The Cross and the Switchblade.
Or was it called Cross and the Switchblade?
Yeah, The Cross and the Switchblade.
Oh. Oh, okay. I can't remember what it was, but it was something like that. It was about Nicky Cruz. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I remember that. Who was a gang member in L.A., I believe, who got born again and set free. But anyway, we watched that whole movie, and it was a really good movie. And then after that, we went to the girl's aunt's house. Well, there was no furniture in this house. It was like an apartment complex. There was no furniture in the living room. And all the kids started, like, doing cartwheels in the living room. And one of the kids was a Satanist. He was sitting down right next to me, and I was talking to him about Jesus. And I looked up and I saw all these kids doing cartwheels in the living room. And I'm like, one of the kids was the girl that we prayed for. You know, and I was like, oh my goodness, you know, you're doing a cartwheel. Do you realize you're doing a cartwheel? And she stopped and she was like flabbergasted. She didn't even realize that she was doing it. She completely forgot. And so I said, take your sock off. And she took her sock off, and her ankle was completely restored. There was nothing wrong with it. And she went back to, I think she was into martial arts at the time. So she went back to martial arts practice the very next day. And so it was kind of cool to see God actually do what his word says, you know. Uh-huh. And, you know, it was the first time I ever seen anything like that, ever, you know. I never, ever seen anything like that. So,
can you think of any other ones that you've prayed for that have been healed?
Not that I have prayed for, but I can think of one other person that I saw when I was going to church in St. Louis.
Mm-hmm.
A girl named Georgia, who everyone knew. Mm-hmm. She could not walk. She always came in a wheelchair. Always came in a wheelchair. And one day in a worship service, she was in the front row like she always was. And she literally sprang up out of her chair.
Woo!
And started doing laps around the congregation. I'll never forget that. She ran around in circles just hollering and hooting.
Praise God.
You know, if you couldn't walk and all of a sudden you could run, you know.
That was pretty cool. That's I'm really sure cool. Everybody yes. in the church was yes. just really saw the power of God that
it,
day.
It was amazing.
Like
it
they
was,
hadn't seen before.
It was really amazing.
Oh, I'm sure it was. Well, we're going to take a quick commercial, and we'll be right back. Thank you.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
If Tom Coates from Consumer Credit of America was your personal webmaster, Tom would filter out all bad debt emails. If Tom was your mailman, you'd never get any debt reduction junk mail. If Tom Coates was a lineman, he'd block any phone calls offering to reduce your credit card debt.
Hi, I'm Tom Coates with Consumer Credit of America, and we're still your best choice for credit counseling. We're local, we're accountable, and we can do more. You make the call when the time's right for you.
When it comes to competition, there really is none for Consumer Credit of America.
Drug and alcohol addiction slowly steals a person's identity. tearing away pieces of their life little by little, until one day it seems like the hope of a happy future is gone and there's no chance of getting it back. Here at St. Gregory Retreat Centers, we can assure you that there is hope. Our unique approach to recovery begins with the understanding that the dysfunction and damage caused by addiction can be overcome, not just dealt with. Don't let another day go by. Call St. Gregory today.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
I was hungry. I was thirsty. I was a stranger. I was naked. I was sick. To the least of these, Holy Spirit-led Ministries is a proud supporter of Impact Ministries International, changing the world together. Find out more at tstammen.com.
Hi, this is Andy Hainer of Full Speed Impact. If you're like me, the message you hear of God's miraculous power on this program builds your faith and encourage you to step out and touch others with God's love. That's why I'd like to share with you some exciting opportunities that Dave and Patty have right now to carry the work of Holy Spirit-led ministries forward in the area of television media, as well as some crucial requests to go into other nations, including Cambodia, India, Africa, and South America, to equip the church and to win the lost with the power of the kingdom of God and the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why I want to encourage you to partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries. Go to their website right now at hslm.us. Click on the donate button to make a tax-deductible contribution, and you will be blessed as you partner with this strategic work to carry the gospel of the kingdom of God into all the world. God is moving right now. Go to hslm.us and partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries today and be part of that move.
And we've got John Orlando and Norman Nelson. And he just played the commercial. We're going to be in Waukon, Iowa, not this weekend, but next weekend, April 5th, 6th, and 7th. So we're going to do a divine healing technician training. So if you can come join us. If you want people to be healed, we're having a healing service Sunday the 7th at 7. So, you know, sometimes God just tugs on people's hearts that they should get into this. That you know that God wants you to lay hands on the sick and watch them recover. So if you've had an interest at all, see if you can be there. You will really just learn so much, and you'll know that you can walk in this too. So please come. We just like to see people trained up walking in this. And I just love to talk about Phoebe, Tina and Andy Hainer's daughter. She's only 8 years old. She's such a blessing. All of his three kids are. They just laid hands on the sick and they watched him recover. But she made a comment the other night at the healing service. We had her get up and give a little testimony of praying for people and watch them be healed and stuff. And she'd seen a lady finger grow out. She'd cut the end of her finger off, and the finger grew out, and the nail came back on her finger. And so that was really cool. I'm like, I haven't even seen that yet. Wow. And she says, and I can't wait to raise the dead. How many eight-year-olds do you know that say, I can't wait to raise the dead? So we'll just say hi to Andy and Tina and their kids. Bless you guys. They are truly a blessing. So, and Andy's going to come with us next weekend in Waukon and help teach. He's a great teacher. And he does stuff for us like that commercial. Yeah, like Dave said, he makes us look really good. So praise God for Andy. And, okay. God told me that Norma was supposed to sing. So, praise God. And she can even sing without music. And it's a blessing. I actually like her to sing without music better because then I can hear her and I don't hear the music. I mean, I like music, but I don't know. When she sings, it's just different. It's hard to explain, but you'll notice when she sings. And Healer, that's our favorite song, and that's the song that God told her to sing. So
when she's singing, if you need anything from the Lord, just expect it to happen.
Amen.
While she sings.
Yes.
Okay.
Praise God.
Well, praise God. Thank you, Lord. You're so awesome. So wonderful. You hold my every moment, and you calm my raging seas. You walk with me through fire and heal my disease, and I trust in you, Lord, I trust in you, 'cause I believe you're my healer. I believe you are all I need. Yes, you are. And I believe you're my portion. I believe you're more than enough for me. Jesus, you're all I need. You hold my every moment, and you calm my raging seas. You walk with me through fire. You heal my disease. And I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you, 'cause I believe you're my healer. I believe you are all, you're all I need, Jesus. And I believe you're my portion. You're more than enough for me. Jesus, you're all I need. Thank you, Lord. You are all I need. More than enough. More than enough for all of us. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Yeah. Thank you, Norma.
That was great.
That just makes my day.
Beautiful.
Praise God.
Well, God spoke to me while she was singing there, and the reason we minister healing is because that's what Jesus told the first 12, the next 70, and all believers to do. The Bible is very clear about that, and the scripture is Isaiah 53:5. But he was wounded for our transgressions, and he was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. But you go to 1 Peter 2:24, he who himself bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, having died to sins, might live for righteousness, by whose stripes you were healed. Amen. Something happened between Isaiah 53 and 1 Peter 2:24. That was the beating. It actually happened. Before, you had to have faith because it wasn't done yet. But we don't have to. It's a done deal. It's finished. It's bought and paid for.
It's already happened. Amen.
It's already happened. We don't have to get it like we got, the old covenant people had to go get it.
Healing's ours.
It's the bread. It's the children's bread.
Children's bread.
Mm-hmm. It's a done deal. It's Psalms 103. Don't forget all of his benefits. That's why we don't get sick. I can't get sick.
Amen.
Right. I know who I am. I'm. That's part of me. Jesus Amen. Is in wow. me. It becomes part of your life. We kill sickness and disease because Jesus told us we should do the same things he did and greater work. Amen. Greater ain't lesser. So a lot of people are just showing you a little Jesus. When he told you to do everything he did in greater works. And you got hundreds of scriptures to back him up. And we've got, JGLM has got millions of testimonies.
Mighty God.
We have over 30,000 miracles a month. Mm-hmm. Nobody even comes close to that.
Yes.
And we don't try to get your money and everything else from it. It's just the gospel. We just preach what the Word of God says. And you just heard Isaiah, that was before the cross. Mm-hmm. And 2 Peter, it's already bought and paid. It's like somebody gives you a vacation package, but you got to get on the plane. You got to get into the kingdom. You got to take your ticket that he bought and paid for, and you got to get on the plane, get on the boat. But when you get on the boat and they pull up to this nice island where all your recreation, if you don't get off the boat, do you ever get on the island? You still got to believe that, hey, it's all paid for. Mm-hmm. I can go and use everything on this whole island, the resort. But most people think, well, you know, Amen. I'm on the boat. And they just sit on the boat and sit in their cabin instead of saying, hey, I don't have to be sick anymore. I don't have to have the devil. The devil is defeated.
Amen.
Well, there's no big devils, no little devils. There's only defeated devils.
Yes.
If all the devils on earth wanted to attack me at one time, I still win.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Because they're all defeated. Jesus defeated. He made a spectacle of them. He made a public display of them. We don't have to get nothing. We just have to know who we are in Christ. That's why we don't preach on the gifts. We don't teach on the anointing. I have the anointed one living in me.
Amen.
And he told me to do the same thing he did in greater works. That's why we get the results we do. We don't have to get nothing. And he's not going to pour out his spirit again. He already did 2,000 years ago. And I use this example. This is all. Now, here's all power and all authority has been given to Jesus, and he tells you to go use it. What do you got to ask me for?
Nothing.
There's nothing you can ask the Father for. He's already given it all to you.
Yeah, it's hard to see what you gave me, but you gave me a pen because the
lining. Well, it's just a point. But once you have it in your hand, what are you going to do with it? You're going to ask, hey, can I have that pen? Can I have it? Can I have it? You got it in your hand. Lay hands on the sick and they shall recover.
Yeah.
Right.
And when you're singing that song, Jesus is all I need. Mm-hmm. Most people will tell you need Jesus plus something. But you can't find a Jesus plus fasting. Jesus plus somebody else's anointing. I don't want somebody else's anointing. I got Jesus.
Amen.
I don't need anything besides what Jesus already did. It's not Jesus plus 10 other things. Then you get into yourself. You get away from the gospel. Paul says, I don't preach anything except Jesus crucified.
Well, just like God told us to do it. He told us to go do it. So that's what we need to do is go do it. And don't ask him to do it because Jesus lives in us. So we just declare things, you know, just receive your healing. And I was just talking to John earlier today. You know, God told us to declare things. So we declare what we want. Me and my household, we will serve the Lord. Just start declaring things into the atmosphere.
Yes.
Whatever your need is, whether it's financial or relationship with any of your family members, no matter what it is, that we just declare things. I kept saying I was going to get a Suburban because I wanted a Suburban. My husband didn't necessarily, but I kept saying it. So, so we did, praise God. And then somebody else gave us a newer one, so we gave the older one away. And we haven't picked up the newer one yet, but we will. So if you need any meetings down in Georgia, we'll come.
We're coming anyway.
Yes,
as long as we're down there. You know any open doors in that neighborhood, and we're setting it up where we can go from Georgia to South Carolina to Florida to Mississippi and Alabama.
Yep, on the way back. Yep.
One of the things I was, when you were talking about, you know, all the power and that everything has already been given to you already.
Yep.
And you get on the boat and you go to this other island and you get, you know, well, like if you ever get on a cruise ship, there's like all kinds of provisions there, man. You don't have to ask anybody. It's already there. Yep. You've paid for it. Like you said, it's already been bought and paid for.
Yep.
So enjoy it, right?
Yeah.
Enjoy it.
Psalm 103.
Enjoy it.
Right.
That's why you don't see us sick.
That's amazing. It's already there.
It's already got all
the provisions of God.
Yep.
Everything you need for life and godliness has been provided for you already.
Right.
So just enjoy it.
Amen.
You're a kingdom child, right?
Yep.
You're joint heirs with Jesus.
Right.
You belong to Jesus. He belongs to you. You know, you're one in the Spirit. So, wow.
Yeah.
You know, we've been adopted. We've been adopted.
Yep.
Into the family of God.
Yep.
So everything that God has in heaven, we have here on earth.
Right.
Through Jesus.
Yep.
That's amazing.
You got it. That's it.
Wow. Praise the Lord.
See how simple it is?
It's very easy.
That's why smart people have a hard time. They overanalyze it.
Like, you want to say I'm not smart?
Yeah. You're actually smarter because you're listening. I'm not either. That's why theologians. And JGM has a forum, and I get to talk to some of the theologians on there. And he says, nobody can figure you out. I said, good. You're just so simple, you go do it. I said, that's what's holding you back, is you got to analyze it.
Amen.
The Bible doesn't say to be led by the brain. It doesn't say to analyze and figure out how God's going to do it.
Amen.
Well, most people are. Yeah. Most people are. And being prophetic and being a seer, I can see. Step one is your spirit is always right and perfect. If you're born again, you got everything right. There is no inner healing.
Amen.
If you need inner healing, you need to get born again. That takes away all that teaching, because the only inner person is the one that should have died, should have had a good funeral for your old man. And Curry's funny about this. He says, you know, I know one of the people that was on the cross next to Jesus. Did you know that? Paul said it. My old man was crucified with Christ.
That's right, yeah.
It's a joke.
You old man. Oh, I got you. Oh, there you go. No, there you go, man. Not too bright, man.
We have too much fun because we know who we are in Christ.
Right.
We know the Bible is absolutely true. And it's the revelation of it. It's not just the words. Anybody can read the Bible, but they can't preach with the revelation of it. What does it really mean? And that's one of the things that Curry and JGLM is all about, and I've been about for years. That's why when I speak, the power of God hits people. And you heard the prophetic words over another prophet called we never met before. He says, you got revelation that the world needs. You know, after you've been dead,
Amen.
Been to heaven a couple times, you know, there ain't a whole lot you're going to learn in this world that, oh, wow, you ought to see this world. That's why it's hard for me to fit in this world. Like, can't you guys get this? It's so simple. He said to come like a child. So what do we teach people to do? Come like a theologian.
Right.
Amen.
So quit being a theologian. Just jump in, join it, get in the river, and just go with it.
Just do it.
Get in
the
river.
The kids, the atheists, they got it right away.
Yes, they do. They don't question it. They just step out and do it.
This is all I got to do, grab their hands. And and we got all kinds of video. We're going to get some more clips up. We got people. Well, hopefully you can help us with that.
Sure.
And we're going to take a quick commercial break. We'll be right back.
From the RE/MAX Real Estate Concept Studios, this is Webcast One Live.
I'm Brian Leach, owner and general manager of Service Legends. I brought along a couple of the home comfort heroes.
Hi, I'm Tammy Wells.
I am Nick Wondershot.
I'm administrative manager.
I'm the senior technician.
From Service Legends.
It seems like every good thing, when you feel it to the bone that it's good, there's a lot of hard work put behind it. I don't think that you can fake it. and have it turn out good.
You know, if we seem like, okay, that's just weird, it's just a furnace, why would you believe so deeply in a furnace? It's not just that, you know, we want to show the world that you can have good service.
Yeah, I mean, it's gotta be, it's your home.
You know, it's built into our daily trainings, it's built into our culture, that we're gonna do whatever it takes to have each client say they love us, period.
That's why we spend all the hours in the training that we do. And if we guarantee it's gonna be a good experience for you, or else it's free, what type of work do you think we're gonna do?
There is a guarantee.
Temperature selection guarantee, fixed rider it's free guarantee, comfort guarantee, best value guarantee, all of these guarantees hold us accountable to ensuring that we exceed your expectations. And if for whatever reason we'd fail and we can't make it right, we guarantee all of those guarantees with 100% money back guarantee.
I mean, if you don't think that your technician can fix it right, are you gonna say that to a client? No.
You don't have to worry about having a technician come to your house.
We drug test, background check all of our team members. We put safe people in your home. Each and every one of our service techs, 400 hours a year in training.
You tell it the minute they walk in the door. They know what they're doing, they've done their homework, and they actually truly care about what you want.
Because at the end of the day, you're the person that makes sure I have a job.
They're gonna be listening. They're gonna wanna know what your challenges are. Then they're gonna come and give you options, and you get to choose.
If I'm there to help and I make it easy and painless, I did my job right that day.
Well, when it comes to your comfort, safety, and your family, you know, you don't necessarily go buy the most expensive, but you get the most bang for your buck.
Oh, it's worth it, because there's a lot of people that will find a way to get it to work right now and then leave and then come back, charge you again, and the cycle just repeats itself. So when I'm out there looking at the furnace, I want to find why it failed today. How can we change the part today with something that you're not going to have to worry about? Is it worth changing the part today? I mean, you can put a lot of money into a furnace. I can fix parts all day. There's good job security in that for me. But is it the right thing for you?
I get a lot of the phone calls of after the technicians are there. They're just in awe. They're like, wow, you guys are great. I mean, I don't even know what to say. You guys are great. Everything you did was perfect. It was great.
Keep going, though. I like this.
Just give us a try. I'm going to take all the risk.
I've got the time to make this right. I've got the support to make it right.
Just check us out.
And if you don't see the value in what we do,
I mean, fixed rider, it's free or 100% money back.
Enough said.
If your knowledge of the Word of God exceeds your obedience to the Word of God, you're backslidden. I don't care how excited you are.
Let me ask you something. Is the Fivefold Ministry really equipping you? Because to me, it looks like they're just exploiting you.
What do you mean you don't have faith? What have they been feeding you all these years? After we're finished training you, you won't have to chase anointings anymore. You'll walk in the one you've got.
Hi, this is Andy Hainer of Full Speed Impact, and if you're like me, the message you hear of God's miraculous power on this program builds your faith and encourage you to step out and touch others with God's love. That's why I'd like to share with you some exciting opportunities that Dave and Patty have right now to carry the work of Holy Spirit-led ministries forward in the area of television media, as well as some crucial requests to go into other nations, including Cambodia, India, Africa, and South America, to equip the church and to win the lost with the power of the kingdom of God and the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why I want to encourage you to partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries. Go to their website right now at hslm.us. Click on the donate button to make a tax-deductible contribution, and you will be blessed as you partner with this strategic work to carry the gospel of the kingdom of God into all the world. God is moving right now. Go to hslm.us and partner with Holy Spirit-led ministries today and be part of that move.
Hi, welcome back to I Believe in Miracles with Dave and Patty Loggie. And we have John Orlando and Norma Nelson. And what we were talking about before the break was about just step out doing it, you know, do what God told us to do. And the other day I was at home and I just kept getting that I was supposed to go to Goodwill. It's like, I didn't know if that was my flesh or what, because I like to go to Goodwill and get bargains, you know, and I just kept getting it. So I went, and so I was walking around and I was looking for who is it that I'm supposed to minister to? You know, there's somebody here God wants me to talk to. So I ran into a relative, and that was very brief. And it's like, okay, well, it wasn't them. And then I ran into another lady and I saw her limping. And so I asked her what was wrong with her. And people always like to talk about themselves, you know, and just struck up a conversation. And then I said, well, you know, I happen to be a minister. I was just wondering if I could pray for you. And she said, well, sure, of course. So I prayed for her. And then, I mean, I didn't know her for a hill of beans. She was a nice older lady. And I just said, after I got done praying, I said, well, would you mind if I just give you a hug? And she said, well, sure. And, you know, sometimes people just are lonely. And so it was just so neat that God brought me across her path. And then we talked a little bit longer and we parted ways. And then I saw her again and she said, you know, I'm just so glad that I got to meet you today. And, you know, it's like it made her day, but it made my day too when God does that. Yeah, and so I told her, you know, about the meetings and services that we have at our house and invited her to come. And so I imagine she will be coming soon. And, you know, it's just so cool when we're listening how God can do that kind of stuff. So do you have anything else that you remember from this last week, honey?
Not right now.
Oh, okay.
We've had so many things. We don't write them down. They happen.
Yeah. I have one. Oh, go ahead. Go.
Somebody at work, I was getting ready to, because I am a trainer at my job, and getting ready to start the class, and a girl came in very distraught, there was nobody else in the room at the time, and I just said, you know, are you okay? And she said, I may have to leave. I got a call that they think my dad's having a heart attack, and it's in another city. I don't know how far away. I don't want to say where, because then that'll say who it was. But anyway, I said, well, she said, they think he's having a heart attack. And I said, well, would it be okay? Can we just pray?
Yeah.
And so I just went over beside her, prayed. She was weeping while we were praying. Mm-hmm. I think God just was giving her a little release right there.
Yeah.
And then I sent her an email, and she said, you know, thank you for your prayers, all is well.
Oh, good.
And then I found out today that they ran tests. They thought he had some damage done to the heart, and all the tests came back that it's fine.
Praise God.
It was actually something with his gallbladder. It wasn't even heart. Uh-huh. But they thought, because of their test results, that it was heart-related, even still. And so then when they ran the further tests, there's nothing with his heart.
Well, you know, it could have been, but God could have just changed it with your prayers.
Yeah, exactly.
Praise
God.
So
she was pretty excited, and she's a brand new employee, so I really hope that, you know, I don't know if she knows the Lord, but I hope that she will.
Amen. Yeah. Well, we need to pray at this time. So, Norma, you can just start, and then John and Dave and whatever the Holy Spirit leads you to pray.
Okay. Father God, I lift up the prayer requests that I got today. People in Texas, there were three different prayer requests, and I just declare that all these prayers will be answered. I speak life and light to every person involved in that prayer request. Lord, you know who they are. Right now, in the name of Jesus, that all is well. Each person will be well. The person that has no brain activity, that their brain will be fine, and that person will be healed. In the name of Jesus, by the power of your Holy Spirit. I also lift up Andre, and we just declare right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, cancer, you die and be gone, never to trouble this young man again. He is healed and restored by the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord.
Father, I thank you for your power and your grace and your mercy that you showed us through your Son, Jesus, who died on the cross for our sins, yes, and rose again by the power of the Holy Spirit. And that same power mends broken hearts. And I just pray for everyone out there that has a broken heart, that your Spirit will comfort them.
Amen.
Because you're the mighty,
yes,
mighty counselor. You're wonderful counselor, mighty God, everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. And you are awesome. You are the great comforter. You comfort people. So I thank you for your comfort. I pray for this nation. I pray for the leadership of this nation. I pray that the Spirit of God will convict all that are doing wrong things and leading this nation down wrong paths, that you'll convict them.
Amen.
And bring them to their knees, and that the revival of the Holy Spirit will reach even Washington, D.C., and spread around the world to other nations.
Amen.
And I thank you for the power of your Spirit, because it's not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit and his power and his might. And I thank you that that is going to take place. It's going to take place right now. And I thank you for all the goodness that you've shown me and other people in this room and around and in this ministry, that will actually be overflowing into the streets and highways and byways of Des Moines, Iowa, Ankeny, Iowa, and the rest of the state, and it'll go down into Missouri, and it'll go up into Minneapolis, Minnesota, and it'll just branch out down to Kansas City, and it'll just flood the whole, because this is the center of the country, God. This is the center of the country, and you're going to pour out your Spirit. Your actually Spirit's going to overflow. It's going to come from us.
Amen.
It's going to come out of us into other people.
Amen.
And it's going to flow into the streets and highways and byways. Yes. It's not going to be sitting inside of churches or
Amen.
Buildings, but it's going to come out of this building, this temple, and other people who are the body of Christ.
Yes.
It's going to flow from the body of Christ. And the joy of the Lord is going to be our strength. The joy of the Lord is going to well up. And I pray for people that are brokenhearted. I just pray for them that you'll give them peace and joy in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hey, speak life into Denise. Her neck, back, you line up now. Ruth, all symptoms of your sickness, disease, cancer, you go now.
Amen.
Go in the name of Jesus. Any hopeless situations, there is no hopeless. And I've shared my testimony. I've been dead, blind, and crippled, and I'm whole. Amen. I've never spent a night in the hospital. I've never had a stitch. And
Amen.
God is no respecter of persons. And he said, only believe.
Amen.
There's nothing else you need to do. It's a free gift. There's nothing you can do to earn it. And we just thank you, Lord, for all the answered prayers.
Amen.
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 Well, there so was... be it is what amen means.
So yeah. be it.
Yep. There was Dick and Pat Green. They had talked to us about this baby that was still in their mother's womb. And when they went to the doctor, they said that something was wrong with the brain, that the development wasn't right. And she did not want to choose abortion, praise God. They were young, the parents, and they were scared. And they just prayed. Other people prayed. And she went into labor last Saturday.
Well, wait a minute. We didn't pray.
We declared in Jesus' name that baby would be born whole and healthy in Jesus' name. And there was a bunch of us. We were at our DHT. And we just believed. And the baby was born on Tuesday. And the brain is normal. There's a little bit of fluid on it. But... the baby was born healthy. There doesn't even have a respirator or anything on it. And so praise God, you know.
Thank you, Jesus.
for that baby. Hmm. And we're just continue Thank to lift God. That baby up. That fluid's going to come off of the brain, and he's going to be healthy and whole in Jesus' name. Huh. So it's Amen. Just so cool when we get those kind of testimonies. How, you know, the doctors thought it was so bad, they suggested that they might have an abortion, and the parents, they didn't do it, you know?
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Praise God. That's just so cool. And the baby wasn't born with a brain injury or not developed. So God is so good, and it's just so cool. We just get testimony after testimony like that, where God just changes things and shifts things. And, you know, it's just our words going out into the atmosphere, just declaring it. It's going to be healthy and whole in Jesus' name.
Well, 2 weekends ago, we had a DHT, Divine Healing Technician training in Des Moines at
Veronica's Church on Southwest 9th.
In the Save-A-Lot parking lot, just the south side, that's a mm-hmm. new church plant. We've seen the lame walk.
Amen.
We've seen the blind could see. The blind lady wanted to drive mm-hmm. home after she read her pamphlet.
Awesome.
And the deaf guy was deaf in one ear, her husband. Uh-huh. I snapped my fingers and he could hear.
Amen. Awesome.
People are coming up and says, I think Jesus is here. Well, I know he's here. How do you know that? Well, Jesus Amen. Lives in me. Why show up? Well, you're prideful. I said, I'm just telling you what the book says. And then I was just reading Acts here about Peter after they healed the blind man or the lame man at the gate. Silver and gold I don't have, but what I give to you. And then the priest come in, and Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, rulers of the temple and elders of Israel, if we this day are judged for a good deed done to a helpless man, by what means he has been made whole? Let this be known to you all and to all of the people of Israel that by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead, by him, this man stands here before you whole.
Amen.
Amen.
It wasn't a suggestion. And I was taught all that stuff. You know, well, that don't happen. I heard all the excuses, the sacred cows. It was a commandment to go heal the sick, raise the dead, and cast out devil. It wasn't an option.
Amen.
It was just, I couldn't get it to, I could get it to work the last decade, but I couldn't teach it until I hooked up with Curry and JGLM. Now we have the best teaching, more miracles than any other ministry that ever walked the earth. I mean, there's not even a close
Praise
second.
God.
And it's so simple. It's just, yes. Hey, go do it.
Check out the website, jglm.org, and just get some of the training. Just listen to it. And
it's free.
Yeah. There's
we
hours and hours and hours of training on John G. Lake Ministries website, so jglm.org. And we've got some of ours, we've done the training, and it's on our website, too, at the hslm.us. We've done a new man series. We've done the divine healing technician training. And it's just, you know, if you're sick, listen to it and be healed in Jesus' name. People have been healed just listening to it. Just
Norma
listening.
Did. What happened when you were listening to one of his teachings?
I had some really large, like, I don't know. Little tumor things, and as soon as he started talking, I could feel the power of God all over me, and they shrunk down. I mean, they were really big. They shrunk down.
Praise God.
Like, just, some of them completely gone. Some of them are just teeny.
They're
tiny.
Going. They're yeah. going. Amen. They don't have a choice. They're going to go totally.
That's right.
And we just want to thank everybody. Ryan, our producer, thank you. He does such a good job. We're not
Where's his
always
camera?
Easy.
Yeah,
to...
yeah.
We're not always easy. We ask for a lot because we
man.
Have a lot to get through. And so praise God. And for Andy, who does a lot of our work behind the scenes, and Michael, who does our website, and he helps me with my Facebook, too, because I'm not very good at that. And Julie, who edits for us. We just want to thank everybody. And Norma and John for their anointed music. So praise God. And so we'll see you next time, same place. But most of all, we just want to thank God for using us. So God bless you.